If you're prone to overwatering or underwatering your plants, a self-watering planter is definitely the best way to go. I am obsessed with LECHUZA self-watering planters. These LECHUZA planters have changed everything. I think they're the best self-watering planters ever. In this video, I'm going to show you the reasons why I think LECHUZA pots are the ultimate pot to use for growing indoor plants, whether you're growing your plants in soil or in semi-hydroponics like Leca. This video is not sponsored by LECHUZA. I have no affiliation to LECHUZA whatsoever. I'm just bringing to you my experience with the LECHUZA pots that I love that I have purchased. Hello, I'm Nora, the Leca Queen. Today I'm gonna show you some of my favorite LECHUZA self-watering planters. I'm also going to show you a few tips and tricks that I use with my planters to take my plant game up to the next level. Let's get started. The first pot is called the LECHUZA Mini Deltini. I have my variegated watermelon peperomia living in this pot, and I think she actually loves it here. I've got this pot in a high gloss white. I really, really love the white aesthetic for all my plants, and that's why I've got this particular pot in this high gloss, and this high gloss just looks so, so beautiful. I actually do love the branding that they've got on the pot there. It just looks really, really lovely. I like it. The LECHUZA Mini Deltini is the perfect addition to your indoor gardening collection. It's a compact and stylish self-watering pot that's perfect for small indoor spaces and small plants. I love that it's got the water level indicator there, and as you can see, mine is halfway up and that plant is really loving it. I love the unique triangular shape and smooth lines of the Mini Deltini pot. I have two Mini Deltini pots. One houses my variegated watermelon peperomia, and the other one houses my gorgeous, gorgeous money tree. Look at how fantastic this tree looks in this gorgeous pot. It's absolutely beautiful, and this plant is thriving. And when I pull that out, you can see where the roots are coming out from there, and that is the reservoir. This wick comes with a pot, and that's what helps bring the water or the nutrient up to the media up there. Now, I did something a little bit different with my pot. I made these additional ventilation holes that I make for almost all my pots for my plants that are living in semi-hydroponics. It's not necessarily something that you need to do, but I feel I need to make these to allow my roots to breathe. So as you can see, I have the ventilation holes in this one, but I don't have the ventilation holes in that one. This plant seems very happy. So to be honest, I think the jury's out as to whether I actually need to make the ventilation holes or not, but I'd rather be on the safe side. So I just do it. But this plant is really, really happy without them. So I don't know. What do you think? Let me know in the comments below. Do you think I need to put the holes, or maybe I shouldn't bother and not put the holes at all? But of course, when you do put the holes, I'm pretty much guessing you can't take your pot back for warranty reasons or anything like that because you've tampered with it. So just keep in mind that if you do want to take it back for whatever reason, do not put the holes in there. One thing that's really great is when you buy a LECHUZA Mini Deltini pot, it actually comes with a little amount of pond, the LECHUZA pond, and that's enough to actually pot up a plant in your Mini Deltini pot. So when you buy one, you've got the pot and you've got the substrate and you're ready to go. All you need is a plant. The Mini Deltini is durable and long-lasting. It's made with very high quality materials. Just touching it would actually give you a sense of how high quality this pot is. It's UV resistant, shatterproof, and easy to clean. It's so easy to clean. A damp cloth glides off the pot so beautifully. If you're finding value from this video, please give it a like and subscribe to my channel. Pot number two is the Deltini. The Deltini is very similar to the Mini Deltini, except of course it's larger. I have my Calicea repens living in my Deltini pot. And yeah, I know, that is my Deltini pot under there. It's a beautiful, beautiful pot. Looks exactly like the Mini Deltini, only larger, and just looks absolutely fantastic. Problem is, my Calicea repens has completely outgrown this pot, and I'm gonna need to change this pot over and actually put a plant in there where I can actually get to see the pot. I don't know what I was thinking when I put it in this one, but hey, you live and learn. It also comes with a sufficient amount of LECHUZA pond, and all you need is a plant and you're ready to get planting away. That's the water level indicator there that you can hardly see because this plant is just completely overgrown. That there is my Calicia repens that's living in my LECHUZA Deltini pot. Next up is my Classico LS 28 Premium. This is my go-to pot for larger plants like this fabulous looking bird of paradise plant. I actually have three plants living in this pot and the plant is just loving it and doing so beautifully. This one comes in my preferred high gloss white color, but you can also get it in charcoal, taupe, espresso, and red. I like this pot because the depth of the inner pot or the liner is 24 centimeters, making it perfect for larger plants. Like all the other LECHUZA pot, this pot is a dustproof, shatterproof, UV light proof, all the proofs that you can come up with, I like, but that's what it is. It's absolutely fantastic. It's beautiful. It works very well. You can have this planter outside. You can have it as a statement piece in your home. And that's why I have this. I have my gorgeous big plants and they look absolutely beautiful in place in my home and match my decor. I love that the liner or inner pot is color coordinated so that the pot just really looks the business. The recessed handles are just genius. They make it so easy to pick up the plant for whatever reason you might need to take it out, maybe to clean out the reservoir, flushing or repotting. The joints between the liner and the handles are flexible, so if it detaches, you can just slip it back in. I really, really think they thought of everything. So I use my Classico a little bit differently than what LECHUZA recommend. I actually make additional ventilation holes in my pot, and I actually also included a wick. You can see that wick going through there. And that's really because I'm growing my plants in semi-hydroponic, and I want to make sure that my Leca balls do not run dry at any point. So I've got that wick there just as a little bit of an insurance policy. So if that's something that you might like to do, it might be helpful if you're growing in semi-hydro. But again, remember, that will probably void your warranty. That is my bird of paradise enjoying life in its LECHUZA Classico LS 28 Premium. If you're enjoying this video, please like and subscribe to my channel. My next favorite pot is the LECHUZA Balconera 50. That's this gorgeous beauty over here. And she houses my Syngonium moss wall. This planter is actually mountable, but I have mine living on a bookshelf. This pot is perfect for my Syngonium wall because it allows me to easily pick up the liner or the inner pot for when I need to flush my plants or clean the reservoir. It's so easy. It has a drain plug, making it easy to drain the reservoir. And like the other pots, it's shatterproof, ultralight, and UV resistant. I'll address the elephant in the room. Yes, LECHUZA pots are pricey compared to other kinds of pots that you can get. But bearing in mind all the advantages of using a LECHUZA pot that I've stated, I think you're not really comparing apples and apples in that particular instance. I'm always looking for a bargain when I need to buy them, and I'm always scouring around looking for where I can get them on sale, and that's when I buy them. And of course, I don't have all my plants living in self-watering LECHUZA pots. That definitely would be way too expensive for me to maintain. I only use the LECHUZA pots for special projects or special plants that I've got that I really want to showcase, and I want them to just look absolutely beautiful in my home, because LECHUZA planters definitely brings the beauty factor. LECHUZA pots also make it very easy to take care of my plants. And so because of this and all the other reasons that I've already stated, even though they are a little bit pricey, it's a sacrifice that I'm willing to make for some of my special projects. While LECHUZA pots might be a great choice for some, it might not necessarily be accessible for everyone. If you want a hassle-free watering experience, moving away from overwatering or underwatering your plants, a self-watering planter is definitely the way to go. And the good news is you can make one for yourself for less than $10, and I'll show you how in the next video.